Today you will learn how to predict or guess the day of the week for any given date from the past or from the future, as long as you keep it after 1600, so Pope Gregory XIII had already introduced the Gregorian calendar. This algorithm is 100% accurate, and with a lot of practice you will be able to do it very, very fast, and by that I mean in a matter of seconds. The best way to learn it is by doing an example. 20th of July 2015. Let W be the variable that you seek for, which in the end will be a number between 0 and 6, and which will give the day of the week. W then is the sum of three terms. D, call it the day term, M, the month term, and Y, let's say the year term. Now D is the remainder after division of 20 by 7, which is equal to 6. In other words, you subtract multiples of 7, or you subtract 7 as many times you need until you remain with something no greater than 6. So D equals 6. The month term, well, a little brain training doesn't hurt. 622, 503, 514, 624. With the exception in the red box for leap years. CGP Grey explains very well when a year is a leap year, links in the description. So if you think it's every 4 years, well, not exactly. Just watch the video. Coming back, 622, 503, 514, 624. You will know it by heart after saying it out loud a couple of times, don't worry. For July, M equals to 5. The year term is also the sum of other three terms, YC, that I call the century term, Y7 and Y4. YC is shown in the upper right table, and for 2015, YC equals to 0. For obtaining Y7, it is necessary to subtract multiples of 7 in the same way as you did with the day term, which is same thing as obtaining the remainder after division of the year by 7. It is important for a calculation of Y7 and Y4 that you only have to consider the last two digits of the year. For 2015, Y7 equals to 1. For obtaining Y4, it is necessary to subtract multiples of 4, but instead of remembering how much you have left, you have to remember how many multiples of 4 you have subtracted. In other words, to obtain the quotient after division of the year by 4. For 2015, Y4 equals to 3. Having all the terms, the year term Y is now equal to 0 plus 1 plus 3 equals to 4. Now the day term, month term, and year term are known, and you only have to add them up, so 6 plus 5 plus 4, the result is 15. Which is very legit, but after 15 days it will be the same day of the week as after 1 day. You see, again, subtracting multiples of 7. So W equals to 1, and our day is Monday. And it will work for any other date if you respect what I said. I assure you it's 100%. If you are into coding, then you can download my MATLAB code that does exactly what I explained. Links also in the description, where you can also find the link to Gray Matter's Mental Gym, where they also treat this problem. In the section tips, they can even offer you MP3s that you can download with input dates and different response durations for the answers, so you can train on different difficulty levels. Plus, they have a bunch of other cool stuff. This is how to estimate the day of the week for any given date, and until next time, goodbye.